Hello, how are you, Nuri?
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm pretty well, teacher.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes,
And you?
I'm pretty good. We're ready to go.
Okay.
Imagine it's already Thursday. Oof. Only today and tomorrow.
Only today, tomorrow. We almost finished.
Yeah, really. Really, that's it. We're just about finished. We only have only the two writing questions for today. That's all that we have, two writing questions, and then the exam, and that's it.
Yes, teacher.
How do you feel with the writing, Nuri?
Some bad.
A little
Oh,
difficult,
teacher,
right?
I think for me it's difficult. I don't feel confident yet.
It's no
But
problem.
I'm here trying again.
But that's how it is, because it's like in Spanish, really. If you have to do a writing for this level, it's not that you don't write. It's not normal to write in Spanish either. So you always need a little bit more help. And today, with the computers, we have spell check, we have Word, we have dictionary. But when you have to write on the exam, it's only what you remember. Do you remember how to spell? Do you remember? If not, no, and that's it.
Yes, and the time wrong, right? We are so stressful.
Exactly. That's the thing. The thing is that you have to go like flash.
Yes,
What can we do, right? We only practice and practice and practice.
yes.
Look at here. We have Mirna. I didn't see Mirna. I don't remember seeing Mirna for many days.
Teacher, only 2 days. I didn't connect it.
The class, only 2 days. No Monday, no
No,
Tuesday, no
Monday and
Wednesday.
Tuesday
So,
only. Ah, teacher.
Hi, Mirna, since last week. How are you, Mirna? Everything okay?
Very well, thank you, teacher. Happy to see you again.
Yeah, me too, Mirna. Remember, Mirna, that tomorrow is the last class.
Yes.
Okay. The idea is today we have a little bit of writing and then we have our last class. Luis, how are you? How was everything?
Everything okay? How are you, teacher and team?
Everything is good. Just, getting ready, making sure that we have all of the people talking about the day. Nuri said her life is excellent. Today was a very good day.
Ah, okay. One more time, free day, right? The same yesterday.
No, I think Nuri, I don't know. Nuri, did you have a free day today?
No.
No, today no, right?
No.
Only Luis
Only
has free
me, only
day.
me. I'm on vacation.
And Mirna, what about you? What did you do? Did you go to another city or another place?
They're not worried.
Teacher, I went to the beach yesterday and it was a happy day.
Okay. Well, now I understand why you didn't come to classes. The beach or class? Me too. Me too. If I have the option, what do you choose, Luis? The beach or class?
When?
Not yesterday.
Yesterday. No, here in my house. Yeah,
Want to
they
be like
celebrate.
Mirna, go to the beach, have some seafood, some fish.
Yeah, good. Yeah, for
Maybe one
seafood.
or two piña coladas, something like this. I
Hijo.
don't
Oh.
know. That's
Oh, for me it was different because my family received what family?
Receive a what, please?
Family, coming.
Family.
Family, yeah. More family. More family.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
you
so
were cooking.
Yes, you receive visits.
No, I can't cook him. But my sister, my aunt, that's my family cooking, right?
Okay.
Luis only?
Yeah, only.
That is
day, Luis coming. You're ready to eat. Yeah, and, but I can't cook him.
En mojitos.
Yes, Nuri. You know, Nuri, that is my favorite drink. That is my favorite alcoholic drink.
I really?
Really, I really like them. I feel that they are very, very calm, not so strong, and you can enjoy, like, when the weather is hot, it's very refreshing. But
yes, it is.
For me, right? Because I know some people, they like beer, or they like other, but I like mojitos. I don't know. I feel like I'm in the Caribbean. I feel like I have one or two mojitos, and life is good.
Yes, I like too.
Hey,
mojitos is a Mexican drink.
Mojitos? No, Cuban. Cuban.
A Cuban. Oh, okay. Fidel Castro, right?
Yeah. With white rum. They make them with white rum.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But I like them. I think they're very relaxing. So, well, guys, today we're going to go ahead and get started. We only have two writing exercises for today. Let me share my screen so we can get started and do our practice. This
and
is
the exam too, teacher.
And the exam. The exam, more or less, Luis, because I'm not sure we have time to finish the exam today, but the objective is that we finish it tomorrow. If we don't finish today, we finish tomorrow, but we're going to try to do as much as we can. Here we have, remember, what is the goal? The goal always is going to be how many words minimum? What is the minimum?
300.
300. You have to have, a good score to get a maximum points, you need minimum 300 words. Okay.
Okay.
Now, today, you have to learn to manage your time. Today, you will have 30 minutes, and you have to plan, write, revise, and send your essay in the 30 minutes. Plan, write, revise, and send your essay in the 30 minutes. Let's take a look at our first question. Nuri, can you please read the question and make sure everybody understands?
Okay. Question. The widespread use of the internet has given people access to information on a level never experienced before. How does this increase in the availability of information influence life in today's world?
Remember, you need to use specific reasons and examples to support your opinion. So first think about plan. How are you going to organize your writing? Then begin writing. Then make sure that you revise and correct anything that you want. Okay? We're going to start with the first one. We're going to have 30 minutes. We're going to go with 25 so that we get more comfortable, so that we have enough time. Okay? And then we're going to send it. One more time. I'll put here in the chat, in case you should have my email, but just in case you don't have my email, I put one more time so that there is no excuse. Did you understand the question, or you didn't understand the question?
May I see the question again, teacher?
Of course. Is there? Okay. It's also in the platform. Remember, writing practice test 2.
Ah, okay.
In the practice. Mm-hmm. No problem. But the most important is, do you understand the question? Do you understand what they are asking you?
But teacher, what does widespread means?
That means the very big or very large usage of the internet. Widespread is expanded.
Ah, okay. expanding.
So that here, Argentina, Canada, China, Russia, this is the widespread use.
Ah, okay.
The question is, okay, how does this increase in the availability of information influence life in today's world? Okay, if we are clear with the question, let's make our partners. Remember, we got 25, we got to get it done. If you're not sure, look for the, try to ask your partner, discuss if you have anything. Okay, we got 25, let's go.
Hello. Good evening, my
Hello,
friend.
Alex. How are you? Don't worry. We're going
Good.
To go to our groups. We are doing writing practice two. Okay.
Okay.
Writing practice two. That's where we need to go. I'm going to share with you the question. That way you can see it just in case. It's in the platform, but I'll share it here with you. It's this question. Make sure you understand the question.
The widespread use of the internet has given people access to personal. How does the increase in the availability of people influence life state or use a particular reason and example to support you? Okay, but the idea is it's like our opinion.
Yes, but remember, you have to use specific reasons and examples on how that information influences the life in today's world.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
Yes.
Good. Okay. I send you to a group.
Okay.
Okay. Don't worry if you haven't finished sending it. I know that it's a little hard, and but go ahead and send it. We're going to go ahead and go on to question number two to make sure that we always feel the pressure, right? We always want to make sure that we are focused on the time. Ivania, can you please read the question number two? What do we need to answer?
Do you agree or disagree with the following statement? There is nothing that an uneducated person can teach an educated person. Use specific reasons and examples to support your opinion.
Okay. So first, before we begin, is the question clear? Do we understand what we are referring to when we are talking about uneducated and educated? We are talking about academically. So an uneducated person refers to someone that does not have academic, for example, high school, university, master's, this is an uneducated, the person didn't go to school. And the educated refers to people that have gone to a school. Guys, is the question okay? It's clear? Now remember, what is the idea when it's this type of question? This is to agree or disagree, right? So when you organize your idea, the first paragraph is creating your statement. Yes, no, why? And then the second paragraph, give the examples, give details, give support. The third one, go for the other, give an opposite opinion or opposite views if you have any. And then the final one is your conclusion, something like this. Remember, the goal is don't write a little. Don't write a few words, 5 words in the sentence. No, try to give details, complete sentences. Be careful with the punctuation. Remember in the exam, I forgot the capital letter. Capital letter, lose points. Everything has to be exactly like is the correct way. It's okay?
Okay.
Yes? All right. Let's go for it. Roxy, you okay? You're having some problems? Okay.